3, 2, 1, go. What's up, guys? I wanted to do a simple tutorial because I get this question a lot, just how to blend shapes together, or like how to put together your meshes and make it really smooth and things like that. So I wanted to do this really simple tutorial, and I'll just use, you know, a few spheres. So now we just have just two spheres here. If you're wondering why mine are this color, it's because I'm using Metcap instead of Lip PBR. Just easier to see. So we have our two spheres here. I'm going to go ahead and validate them. And let's say we just want another sphere. So I'll just add another sphere here. Oh, let me take it out of this mirror, because if it's in a mirror, then it's going to be mirrored. So I'll take it out of this mirror. I'll validate it. And let's just add it like, just to have some variety to our shape. You might be tempted to just hit join to join them. So let's select all these. I'll validate this. So let's select all these spheres. If you hit join, you notice that they still look separate even though they're together. So this is good when you have to move all of them around or do something with all of them. You can color them all together, but they're actually not like fused together. If you try to move them, they just move like still as though they're individual. So that's join. And the thing about join is you can always go in to your sphere and you can separate, and then you'll have everything separated again. So that's join. So if you want to put them together so you can smooth them, just select all of your spheres, hit voxel, and let's remesh around 200. So now they're voxel remeshed. You can see they're actually together. Voxel remesh or voxel merge, same sort of thing. It's a remesh unless you have two. If you have two, then it's voxel merging. If you don't, then it's voxel remeshing, but it's the same thing. So you just want to remember to voxel remesh your shapes together. That will fuse them together. Then you can smooth. Then you can smooth everything. But it's also important to know like what you're doing. See, this is pretty good if you're making like a piece of popcorn or something. But if you really want them to smooth out completely, then what you do is voxel remesh at a really low number. So like say I did 50. That's a really low voxel remesh. So now I'll take my smooth tool and notice how this is exceptionally blending them together to where you don't even really know that they were ever separate pieces. Same thing being said, so when you voxel remesh low, everything is gonna look kind of bad. Like let's say you wanna use like crease. See, it doesn't really look good because your mesh is very low density and you need high density if you want to do detail. So let's say we wanted to up the detail and instead we voxel remesh at 500. And I'm just using the shortcut. This is the same as if we went up here, voxel remesh at 500, it's the same thing. So we have all these things, we can smooth them out. But when you remesh high, then you have more detail because your mesh is a lot more dense. See, it's a lot cleaner. Same thing goes for paint. Same thing goes for the other tools. So this is how I make things super smooth. Let's say, for example, I was making like lips on here or something like that. Like if I was gonna make lips, I would do that. Now, when you add clay or something like that, you are able to smooth that pretty easily, even though it's a high density mesh, you know? So I would do something like this, and then I would flatten it out. And I'd probably smooth it again. And then I'd take the crease, and I'd do, you know, like a lip shape or something like that. So that's how I would do it, but I'm constantly smoothing out around the base, things like that. And if I needed to go even smoother, I might voxel remesh it a little bit lower so then I can smooth things out a little easier. You know, do some more work to it. Maybe use the pinch tool. Smooth it out a bit. And then I might remesh it higher again. I might remesh it higher and then do details that I want to be, you know, super crisp. So that's the magic. It's just remeshing higher and lower and just getting used to that. And that's how you can get great detail with your mesh. All right. Keep drawing, keep sculpting. I'll see you all in the next video.
Thank you so much for watching the video. Be sure to like and subscribe. It really helps me, helps my channel. And if you're really serious about learning, then definitely check out my Skillshare classes. Just go to drugfreedave.com. So just go to my website. I have a bunch of classes in 3D with Nomad Sculpt. And I also have 2D classes in Procreate. Keep drawing, keep sculpting. I'll see you all in the next video. Thank you.